Another six stops on the Thursday night prep docket. What do you say we start north of the 52? Palomar League matchup at the Rancho Bernardo Gym. Lady Broncos host Westview. That's Julia Kalen with one of her 15 kills to give RB the one-set lead. But it would be Sabrina Sparati collecting a team-high 11 kills. The lead, the Wolverines back. They win in five. Heading over to the UC University City, Lady and Centurions welcome Benita Vista. In the opening set, Centurion Maya Arriaga with one of her team-high 17 digs. And then in the second set, UC's Julia Cowell with one of her two aces right there, the righty delivering. Centurions winning a sweep, 3-love. Over at Hoover, the Lady Cardinals host Morrison, a preview of tomorrow's PPR football matchup between the two schools. Hoover's Jacqueline Miranda goes down the line for one of her five kills. Lady Cardinals win the first two games. And in the third, Madeline Rosales powers one of her game-high nine kills as Hoover wins in straight sets, the final 3-love. Now time to get wet. Over at Mount Carmel, the Sun Devils playing host to Eastlake. This is Eastlake's Josh Randall hitting the back of the net to get the Titans on the board. But Bryce Close and Armand Sarkani combined for seven goals as the Sun Devils win this one in double OT, the final 8-7. Over at Claremont, the Chieftains taking on Scripps Ranch in the third quarter. Falcons' Tanner Collins passes to Stone Parker, who scores one of his game-high four. Nice team passing here by the Chieftains before Jake Stone. Make that Jack, man, it's Jake Stone, scores his third goal as Claremont wins it 18-6. And what do you say we finish up at Sarah? The Conquistadors putting their 47-game win streak on the line as they host La Costa Canyon field hockey. Late in the first half, Sarah's Tyler Sanderson converts his goal from a difficult angle. Q-Dogs up four at the break. In the second half, check out the stick handling of Sarah's KP Peterson. She goes through two defenders. You know, everyone's gaga about the Indians. This team has won 48 in a row. The final 6-0. Week four of the Prep Picks Report. Now inside the 30-hour launch window. Just a reminder, our Stomino Snapchat filter goes live at every ballpark around the county at 6 p.m. Use that filter for your snaps on Friday, and you can pick up free bread twists with your walk-in pizza purchase at your local Domino's. And the Corvette Diner Rally, the Corvette Diner Rally with Allie is at Olympian. Make sure to check out all our prep rally photos on KUSI.com, PPR. Find the one that features Derek from Domino's. See the one, that you see the little pig in back? All you have to do is retweet that picture out on all our social media platforms, and you get a $20 Domino's coupon. It's that simple. Right now, here's Brandon Stone in the Miramar College Student Athlete Spotlight.
When the Dons need that extra yard, they've got the perfect man front and center.
I was on Scripps Ranch, Pop Warner. Coach Doyle was our defensive coordinator.
Hey, what position do you play? I don't know, I've never played before.
My dad told me to come into the first day of practice saying, I'll play whatever you want me to play as long as I get to play.
I said, what's your last name? He said, center. That's a great spot for you.
Coach Doyle said, this kid's gonna play center for us, and then the rest is history.
It was great, because he was real quiet at first. But it's like, hey, Hayden, you got to take control of the huddle. It's like, huddle up, you know, it's a quiet huddle. He was perfect at it from the get-go.
I know on every single play what every single one of my linemen's supposed to do and how they're supposed to do it, and that comes with just a lot of experience.
He is so smart. Even sophomore year, you know, you'd go down the line of scrimmage on a certain play, what do you do? And he would be saying it. You seal, you scoop, you go linebacker. He knows every position and has since sophomore year.
And when you need a lineman that plays like a machine, you find the guy who's wired in.
I've always been kind of a dorky kid, just into that kind of thing, but I was able to last year build my own computer and do that. I've been able to program websites, and it's just, you know, it's just something I found that I had a knack for and something I love doing.
He can go out and build this computer, put the software on it that we're using in the class, write programs on the computer, build programs with the skills he's learning here for himself. Aiden usually takes that and does his own project to start with. So he'll be, oh, I could do something cool with this information, and he'll go out and do that.
From Cathedral, this is Brandon Stone for the All Sports Report.
And you do really good work. Photographer extraordinaire Chris Smith is a unique individual, a software engineer by day for Sony. When the sun goes down, Top Dog 619 becomes one of the leading voices in San Diego sports. He's one part photographer, one part social media guru, and now we're happy to announce one part PPR red jacket. Look for Top Dog every Thursday on the KUSI Sports Rail.
You know, last year, you and I met at the CIF game last year, and I gave you a hard time about Scotty Young not being up there, right? Sitting on the other side of the fence right now, I can tell you it's a very difficult decision. You've got 7,000 football players in San Diego, and you've got to narrow it down to the best six players in the entire county. That's a very tough decision to make.
All right, that said, season ends tomorrow. Let's make it six chairs. Who's going to be there if you were king for a day? If you were pig for a day.
Pig for a day, okay. Well, my dog list, I guess you want to say, since it's my list. I'm going to start off with Jack Tuttle. Jack Tuttle is going to be one guy on the list. I'm going to take Moses Mooney from Bishops. I'm going to take Kyle Phillips. I got a trio of running backs that I love. I'm going to take Chris Brown. I'm going to take Kenyon Sims, and I'm going to take Martell Irby.
Boy, there are going to be some Helix Scotties. The Helix Six are going to have two players on that podium. You didn't have one.
Well, you know, for me, it's not just the big star of the big football program. It's the kids that show leadership, show character, that they fight every Friday night for their team. Martell Irby is a prime example. That is an excellent student athlete that I have a tremendous amount of respect for.
Thank you, Chris. Next up, La Jolla, the Lawrence Family Jewish Community Center, playing host to boxer Paul Vaden. Thursday night, Paul airing his life story in a documentary titled Vaden Versus. The former IBF light middleweight champ has a story to tell. A lot of you know it. He's best known for being in the fight with Steven Johnson. Yeah, he KO'd Johnson in the 10th round. 15 days later, Johnson died without ever regaining consciousness.
Paul Johnson is still down. But doctors look over.
That was very important to me to be able to hopefully have a positive impact, let him know my story and understand specific storms that I had endured and how I worked my way through.